this question comes to me sometimes when reading slightly difficult readings like J. Krishnamurti or Ramana Maharshi. What is, say, a fundamental difference between reading a scripture and reading, let's say, an advanced science textbook? Because both of them are to be read by the ego, in a way. And both of them are to be understood. So what is...
The subject is different. When you read an advanced book in science, the subject is always an object that you sensually perceive. It could be a very complex subject, it could be a very intricate subject, it could be a very fine subject, it could be down to the atomic levels or even deeper. Or it could be as expansive as the universe itself. But nevertheless, the thing that you explore in the scientific domain is something outside of yourself. When you read a spiritual text, that which you are exploring is the I. That's the difference. Science will never explore the I. It doesn't even intend to.
From the point of view of understanding, is there
of
something
course,
different?
Both require attention. Both require deep attention, honesty. But when you read a spiritual text, besides attention and honesty, it also requires an urge for liberation. You could be a great scientist without having any urge for liberation. But you cannot be a great spiritual seeker without having an urge for liberation. So, obviously, the spiritual seeker needs to have a greatly scientific attitude. 99% qualities have to be common between the scientist, the researcher, and the spiritual seeker. 99% qualities are going to be common. But there is one additional quality that the spiritual seeker will have that the scientist is not supposed to have. What is that? An urge for liberation. Which means, please understand, that the spiritual seeker will necessarily have a scientific attitude. The spiritual seeker will have a scientific attitude plus the urge for liberation, which entails that you cannot have a spiritual seeker who is unscientific, irrational, illogical. Are you getting it? You cannot have a spiritual seeker who is unscientific, irrational, and illogical. This too has become fashionable in spiritual circles these days. They say, oh no, we aren't really materialist scientists. We are spiritual seekers. We don't use logic. Who convinced them that spirituality is about illogic? They start talking of all kinds of metaphysics without even understanding basic physics. Who convinced them that spirituality is about irrationality? The spiritual seeker will be greatly rational. There is no doubt about it. He will be as rational as the rationalists. And if you find an irrational spiritual seeker, then some kind of scoundrel perpetuating a scandal, a hogwash, something. So now you know what differentiates the spiritual seeker from the scientist. Just one quality. An urge for liberation. All other qualities must be the same. In fact, it will be very difficult to separate the two. the way they question, the way they approach a topic, the way they want to understand, their integrity, their intensity, will all look very alike. A scientist is very, very, in fact, close to being a spiritual seeker, very close. If only he could just have a little bit of longing for freedom, he would be a perfect saint.
Last small question related to the same thing. Like in science, we build up on knowledge, right? Easy knowledge and then, you know, progressively difficult. But sometimes in the spiritual, is it similar in...
Of course, in spirituality, there is a definite place for acquired knowledge. So you read books that are written by others. At the same time, in spirituality, you have to know the knower. Knowledge comes from outside, the knower sits within. So that is an enterprise you have to undertake on your own. In that, no knowledge can help. But that doesn't mean that knowledge is useless in the spiritual domain. The spiritual seeker too needs knowledge and a lot of knowledge, just like the scientist. But the spiritual seeker needs something over and above his knowledge. What does he need? He needs to keep an eye on the knower. And that cannot be done via knowledge. That has to be done real time. Knowledge is static, while keeping an eye is a dynamic process. It happens in the present, real time. Knowledge is all static. You can take something that was written 20 years back and, you know, gulp it down. So that is the kind of vigilance that spirituality requires. Science does not require that kind of vigilance. That doesn't mean that science does not require vigilance. But the intense, rigorous self-observation that spirituality demands is alien to science. You can easily find great scientists, very mature and decorated scientists, who have very little self-knowledge. They will be capricious, envious, jealous, and all kinds of inner traits would be there, and it's quite possible that they might be totally oblivious of it. So you can be a great scientist even without having much self-knowledge. But you cannot be a spiritual seeker of any standing if you fail in self-knowledge. And self-knowledge, I repeat, is not knowledge really, it is continuous knowing, it is dynamic. Therefore, it is very, very demanding. It is an inner discipline. You have to keep knowing yourself.
So, does the type of spiritual literature one reads also depend on the type, on the quality of the knower? Or are there levels, like, as I said, in science,
yes,
there
is
easy?
Yes. Easy, you just difficult. Cannot pick up any spiritual book and find it to be useful for yourself. That's not going to happen. You have to go about it preferably in a structured way. That doesn't mean that spirituality cannot be a wild tree in the jungle. It is possible that you just grow and branch out on your own and still achieve fullness and fruition. It is possible. But it is advisable to go about the spiritual process too in a guided and structured way.